Hello, fishies. Welcome back to another one of our Smash Mural speed paints. This one is, of course, Pokemon Trainer to go with the three starters that we had for the last 3 weeks. And I hope you guys had a good Pokemon day. I know some people were underwhelmed with some of the announcements that day. My husband's very much been looking for a Black and White remake. I blame Oshawa for his obsession with that region. but anyways, my favorite game, probably for not the same reason, but like it was one of the first ones I finished, was Soul Silver. But today I wanted to talk about the trainer designs and the games that they come from. We're gonna start with Red from Red and Blue, and I believe Yellow as well. Those games were on the Game Boy/Game Boy Color. I did play Yellow a little bit, but I didn't really play Red or Blue. But he's got a pretty basic design, heavily based on Ash. And you start those games with a Pikachu. And I think, you know, it's just kind of a nostalgic, kind of simple design. Very much goes based off the anime. And then the next games to come out were Gold and Silver, with the playable characters. Well, it was just Ethan, and then the other one came out in the third game, Crystal. Her name was Chris. They had like red hoodies, and then there was a lot of like black and gold in their outfits. Very reminiscent of like the Ultra Balls. Oh, he's got it in his hat, and they both have like yellow and black shorts and big chonky shoes, because you know all character sprites need the chonky shoes. It's a must. And then the next ones were May and Brendan. Brendan, yes. From Ruby and Sapphire. May, again, is basically pulled straight from the anime. But she was always a cute character. I think my favorite movie that was like in that era was probably Destiny Deoxys. Or the one with Jirachi, which it can't be my favorite because I can't remember the name of it. but I thought she was a cute character. My favorite like female counterpart, though, will probably always be Misty. Nobody can change my mind on that. I will die on that hill. but their outfits are pretty simple. Again, black and red, because red is the main Pokemon color, because Pokeballs. And then in that one, they both had like bandanas instead of hats. She was just like more in shorts, and he had like the long pants and the big red shoes. And then the ones that Smash Ultimate Pokemon trainers are actually based on are Red and Leaf from Fire Red and Leaf Green. The girl has like a cute little top hat, little red skirt, and like a blue tank top. And the guy, of course, looks like this. I think their designs are pretty nice. They're pretty basic. I like how the hats are like opposite colors. I think that's a fun little detail. Then Brennan and May are also in the Emerald game, but they're basically just color swapped to have green accents and more orange in their outfit than red. Then Diamond and Pearl came around with the Sinnoh region, bringing Dawn and Lucas. Lucas has a very spiffy hat. He has a nice scarf. Bright yellow backpacks for both of them. Dawn, of course, has her pink highlights instead of the red, which makes it a little bit different, but she still has a red scarf. And in Platinum, she has a full-on red dress. I thought she was like a cute character. I didn't like her in the anime though. I don't know why. I guess I also stopped paying attention to the anime around that time. Maybe it's because I didn't connect as much with those starters. I don't know. But anyways, I think Dawn's cute. I just don't like her as a character. And then there was a Gold and Silver remake called Heart Gold and Soul Silver, which had new character designs, except Ethan was still the same, except he had black cargo and short leggings. No, not leggings. But they kind of came to like a gather at them. And then we got Lyra, which I really liked. Her design is probably one of my favorites. And I mean, if you saw our Pokemon rating, our Pokemon tier list, sorry, that's what it's called, you'll notice that that's the outfit that I chose for my character, because that's one of the first games that I ever finished. I remember it was on like my DS. It was a DS Lite. It was bright pink. I don't think I fully ever evolved my Feraligatr though, or my Totodile. I know I started with Totodile. My main Pokemon though became Togepi and turned into a Togekiss. I think that's like the main Pokemon I always choose for those games. Oh, I guess I forgot a random line. That happens sometimes. And then my husband's outfit is based on Hilbert, which that name is kind of tragic. I'm sorry, Hilbert. I hope you didn't get bullied. But Hilbert is from Black and White with a blue coat, the only red accents being his hat and his shoes, and then just the gray pants. I thought it was a very simple design. I kind of like the blue jacket. He looks a lot more mellow than the rest of them. Like, after that point, they started having the guys mostly in blue. And then Hilda, I always thought her design was cute with, like, the, you know, torn-up shorts, big floofy ponytail, a little vest thing. I mean, they also have armbands. There's a lot of... I think this is about the time when... Nah. There's still a lot of bare hands. There's just a couple games where they always wear gloves. Like, going back to Ruby and Sapphire, they were always wearing gloves. I don't know, maybe it's colder in the Hoenn region. Who knows? But then... After that, we have Nate and Rosa in Black and White 2, which I kind of forgot there was a Black and White 2. but he's also in the blue jacket, Nate is, with these cool like blue leggings under oversized basketball shorts. And his hair is very floof. He's only got like one of those tennis visors. Across the shoulder bag, which most of them are across the shoulder. I mean, for the guys, and there's also a lot of backpacks too, but it is what it is. And then Rosa has a like bright yellow skirt, some leggings, another visor, and like these twin buns that are huge. I think if she were in the newer game, she would have a dox bun, because she looks like a dox bun. My husband's favorite character, or favorite Pokemon in the newer games, is Doxbun. And then after that, there was... I think they got kind of lazy on the naming for X and Y, but it's Heroine and Hero. And again, the girl is in all red. She's got like a cute little red top hat with sunglasses on it and a little red skirt. He's in a blue jacket. Kind of sporty looking, also with sunglasses on his hat. And then in the future we got to customize them more with like sword and shield, but they still had like their basic designs. There was Gloria and Victor for Sword and Shield. You had, like, a weird-looking grandma hat for Victor. I hated that hat. Like, as soon as I could physically take that hat off, I did. And he's got, you know, the big old box backpack, red shirt. And then Gloria, she's got her cute little Scottish pom-pom hat, big sweater, pink dress, and shoes, big boots. I think it's fun that they've tried to keep, like, regions for all of these to be in, to try and make it kind of all the same. Well, you know, kind of relating back to the world we live in, as opposed to just being, you know, unattainable or just in Japan. I couldn't tell you exactly where all of them are supposed to be based, but, you know, it's just fun seeing all the cultural references, and I wish we had the chance to, like, travel more and see all this culture firsthand, but, you know, it's fun that they're making the effort to incorporate it. And then in Scarlet and Violet, we do have some basic names for them. It's Juliana and Florian. Florian just reminds me of a prince from a movie that I can't remember now. Where is Prince Florian from? Prince Florian is from somewhere, I promise. Okay, I'm making you Google this right now. It's so important. It's gotta happen. So, Prince Florian is... Oh, okay. Florian is Prince Charming, but also it is the little caterpillar dude in the Mario Wonder Games. So, I'm not crazy. He does exist. I guess now knowing that he's supposed to be Prince Charming, that's kind of fun. And their basic outfits are kind of dorky looking, like the little short sleeve shirt and tie and the big chonky shorts. Big hats. I don't know. I didn't like the like main design. I think I always went for the fall variant with my character. But the original one has the girl with like the just single braid and the boy just with like the kind of shortish basic hair. I also... This is another one. Kari and Rei from Legends Arceus. Sorry, my brain just did not work for 2 seconds. We all have those moments. It's fine. I thought it was really fun that they were based on Dawn and Lucas, and you can kind of see that in their hats and hair. And, like, then you have the old traditional clothing. Which, I don't know a lot about old traditional Japanese clothing. I mean, I'm kind of a weeb, but I'm not that much of a weeb. But I can still appreciate that it looks nice. Out of all of them, like, design-wise, I'm probably gonna go with Lyra as my favorite. That's probably with a high bias. But without bias... I can't judge these without bias, let's be honest. Anyways, I really like the designs and their outfits. I would eventually like to open up commissions just to, like, draw maybe some of your guys' characters in these outfits and, you know, with a Pokemon of your choice, kind of like this or, like, our tier list videos. If you guys are interested in that, please reach out to us. We'll have, you know, contact information in our linked in the bio and all that jazz. Just reach out if you're ever curious. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!